Jimenez.
And why are you here today, Ismael?
I'm here to support other people who feel like the prison statute should be taken down. I think it is a blemish on the city of Philadelphia, and that holds us back from moving forward in race relations within this city.
Thank you so much.
My name is Ismael Jimenez. I am a member of the Teacher Action Group, but also the Philadelphia Black History Collaborative. I'm a teacher in the Philadelphia School District. I've been teacher for about 9 years. I worked at Germantown High School when they closed it down. Every single school that they talk about closing down, 95% of those students are black and brown students. And this is the situation that we're talking about that is the real issue here. This statue is just a reflection of the white supremacist structure that all of us are indoctrinated with.
Yes.
Regardless of what race you think you are, we all have been taught since we were little children to believe that God is white and the devil is wrong and he's black. And see, this is the reality that's already embedded in our minds from a little child. Now, as a teacher, this might sound weird coming from me, but as an African-American history teacher, it's the reality. From the very beginning, racialized exploitation built this country. And the police force was created in order to protect the moneyed interest of the business and the elite class.
Yes, yes.
There's no coincidence that Rizzo came to power during the 1967 era. That era, you saw the culmination of struggle from years and years of civil rights movement where people started to realize, wait a minute, just because down south they don't have segregation anymore doesn't mean that me living in Philadelphia means anything. I'm still stuck in the hood. I'm still stuck in the school where the teachers look at me like I'm a criminal, like these people look at us. And you need to realize, when we're out here, you have to read, you have to learn, you have to be, you have to experience. Just looking at and yelling at these people ain't going to change anything. They look at us like we're animals. And we're going to reinforce that idea if we don't read and outthink them and be smart.
Right.
And we're not talking about being smart, I'm talking about moving in formations that are critical of ourselves and of the society in which we live in. No way am I just going to simply co-sign anybody that talk about anything. This is the reality. Rizzo represents the barrier that we all exist in today. The reason why these white people want to come out here and be like, keep the statue up, they're taking away our history, is because we are taking away their history.
Yes.
We're trying to tell them
that white and rape folks, that's right. That's right.
Fascism,
that's right. That's right. Ignorance. Yes.
And they use black people against us too. You best believe, just because it got a face that is black and brown does not represent our interests. If anything, they learned from the 60s and 70s while we're still hustling backwards. We're still begging for a piece of the pie in the kitchen that we can never enter.
Money ain't everything. Money's not everything.
So when I speak to you as an educator, as a teacher, I need everybody out here to recognize all this has happened before. All these conversations about police abolition, all these conversations about police brutality, all these things have existed from the very beginning of this racialized, exploitative society.
Yes.
And until we recognize the history and truly understand what it means, we will never get free.
Yes.
Power to the people.
Power to the people.
I'm finding so many different mentalities. It seems challenging. I don't say hard because the only thing hard is the concrete that you walk on. Everything else is a challenge. So I'm ready for this challenge. And I was built.